Let's see. Let's see who we have. It is right. It's Team Aze versus Team Resurrection. On screen right now is Team Aze's ace playing Heihachi. He's been known to play a lot of Mishima characters, but decided to go with Heihachi in Tekken 7. And going up against Ace is Team Resurrection's Chanel. Chanel has picked Alisa as his main character. And Chanel is the only player in the entire tournament to go with Alisa. I'm surprised that not many players pick Alisa. But let's see if Chanel can prove everybody wrong by showing how strong Alisa is. There are a few characters that only one player has selected in the tournament. Another example is Lars. In Team Aze, which you can see on the left side of the screen right now, Team Aze only practice is the only player in the tournament to pick Lars.
Round one.
So we have some unique fight picks prepared for you in this matchup. Alright, Ace versus Chanel. Heihachi versus Alisa. Good low parry. Conversion, wall. Nice damage. Both players fishing. Ace threatening with the electric.
KO.
And the wake up mix up gets him. Round one, Ace. Oh! That was even a counter hit launch. This has to be big. Oh, perfect! Ace! 2-0, quickly. Chanel, show us why Alisa is good, please. Is there a reason why nobody picks Alisa except Chanel? Prove us wrong, please. Whoa. The electrics are too much. The break. Pressure. Pressure from Ace. Chanel, he needs to do something. Ace. He can finish it off. Not quite. It's all down to one mix-up. Nice punish. One hit could do it. Oh, Chanel. Stays alive.
Round four. Fight.
That's round score is 2-1. Ace. Ace showing that he's a confident player. That he's ready. It's up to Chanel to show what he's prepared for the tournament. Why is Chanel whipping all those moves from so far away? Does he think that Ace is going to be charging at him at those instances? Is that why? Regardless, nice break. It's a low. And Ace quickly taking it. He's happy. He's out of the seed. High-fiving everyone. He's very happy. He's nodding his head. Chanel looked distinctly frozen in that game. He cannot be happy about that. I'm sure Nee, the player sitting beside Chanel, is going to be giving him some tips. Tell him to regroup. You do have one more chance. Right, up next for Team Resurrection is Narakop, Korea's premier Paul player. But for some reason, you know, Paulie is a very strong character in Tekken 7. But for some reason, he decided to go with Claudio for the tournament. So, Korea's premier Paul is going to be playing Claudio. And that's
round one.
Hey, Heihachi versus Claudio.
Fight.
It's not a cop. The first blow. Oh, I thought that was gonna be an extension. Nice install. Nice flank install. Not a cop. Not giving Ace any chances. Quickly. Finishes
round
it off.
1-0. Fight.
So this particular stage is so brutal for the player getting launched. Like right here. It's very easy to break the floor multiple times. And this time it's Ace breaking the floor, extending the combo, cornering Narukov. It's a very momentum-based stage, I might say. Both players taking a breather. Fishing. But Narukov. Oh, two low shift blocks in a row.
Round
and it's,
three.
It's a Aaron fight. High kick. That nets Narukov round number two. 2-0. Narukov. Ace not able to play an offensive game that he showed in game one against Narukov. Narukov with a nice counter hit. We're gonna break the floor once again. Look at his damage. Oh, he got the low, but he didn't finish, but now he will. Quick 3-0, Narukov. always a fun personality at tournament. A good spirit. It makes even the other guy, makes the other team laugh a little. Oh, that's what it's all about.
Can you feel my broken spirit?
Tournaments are tournaments. You're supposed to have fun. Usually the player having fun also does better. I've noticed. But then, you know, if you have too much fun, you might let your guards down. So it's difficult to say. But based on his gameplay, Narukov's gameplay, and the quick 3-0 result, Narukov is in form.
Right,
Team Aze only practice. The only Lars in the tournament. Let's see if the only Lars is... Whoa! I just lost my words. The tension is just too much. I think I'm gonna like this fight. I'm seeing what kind of style Only Practice is gonna go with. It looks like we're gonna see a lot of attack, a lot of aggression from both players. Good block, but Narukov gets the hopkick. Off the combo into flame install. Counter hit. Almost. Nice block. Round score is now 1-1. I'm sorry, guys. We're gonna have to restart from 1-1. Round score 1-1. Looks like Lars and Cloudy are both aggressive characters in these players' hands. Welcome back. It's time for me to be on the camera. while the referees set up the resuming match. This matchup we have right now is going to feature two characters that only these players have picked, Alisa and Lars. Alisa, picked by Chanel, hasn't done so well. He does have another chance, so let's hope that he does better in the next time, in the next match. But we also have another character specialist, Lars, in Only Practice. And it looked like he might be doing a little better than Chanel. Let's hope we have more variety character-wise for the tournament. And let's hope we get a better match each time. I want to see some good matches. This is the qualifying match for Pool B. And it's only going to be higher matches tournament-wise. It's only going to be higher matches from now on as time progresses. So expect to see high-level matches. Expect to see famous players. Expect to see some hype moments. And I'm excited. I'm having fun. All right, let's see if there are any more interesting information. I have some nice little stat here. We have, for those who might be curious, we have one female contestant out of the 93 people, or 31 teams of 3-on-3s. We have one female player who's playing Jin. Well, let's see if we get to see her team on stream also. And also, like I mentioned previously, Team 3 Generations is the only team in the entire tournament with only Mishima characters. Thus, the name 3 Generations. Also, the team we have up on stage has Nii in one of the teams, Team Resurrection. And Nii, who's traditionally known for Brian, has decided to go with Shaheen this time. It might be a sign that Shaheen is a very strong character. It might be Nii, the player Nii, saying that he has other options besides Brian. We'll just have to see. After we get back to the match, after we resume the match. And let's see. The tournament is going to be a weekly thing. Will always be live broadcasted. 2 weeks from now is the first week of the main tournament. So first week, that's July 19th. July 19th, we had to take a quick break, and we're now preparing to get back into the match from where we left off. I'll cover you guys from where I left off. So today is going to be a long day of qualification matches from 8 pools. Total of 16 teams make it out to the main tournament. 2 teams from each pool, and for the first time around, each winning team from each pool will be qualified. And after that, the remaining 3 teams from each pool will be given another chance to make it out to the main tournament. So it's like a double take, you know, double pass. And we're going to have our 16 teams at the end of the day today. And afterwards, when all the teams have been decided, we're going to have an 8-week marathon. Each Sunday, starting with July 19th all the way through September 6th, each week is going to feature tournament matches from the main tournament. And the finals, the main tournament, is going to feature a slightly different format. From top 16 to top 8, it's going to be a tournament format in each groups. So teams are going to be split into groups. And from each group, I guess half of them are going to fall down. and get eliminated, and half of them are going to advance to top eight. Or top four, rather. So from top 16 matches to top eight matches, you're going to have group matches. And from top four to grand finals, you're going to have a regular tournament. So that's the format, and it's going to be the same format as right now, which is two lives for each player. So six wins will give the team a match in advance. The prize pot for the whole tournament is about $27,000 or 27 million Korean won. And first placing team gets $15,000 roughly. The second placing team gets about $9,000, and third placing team gets about $3,000. So a lot is on stake. Everybody who's good at this game is out and playing. It's gonna be a long day today, but I'm excited to see all these good matches. And as you can see up on the screen, from the main tournament and onward, it's gonna be a tournament format. First of all, top 16 to top 8, it's gonna be groups, and from top 4 to grand finals, it's gonna be a tournament. The format of the tournament is a 3-on-3 team battle with character lock. The main tournament will start on July 19th and run all the way to September 6th, a total of 8 weeks. And then the rundown of the prizes, like I just mentioned. Who do you think is gonna win the whole tournament? And I know you haven't seen all the teams yet, but based on what you've seen so far, what characters do you feel are strong? What teams look strong? What do you want to see? Regardless of who looks strong, who do you want to see? What do you want to see? Let us know. We'll do our best to put those matches on the stream for you to enjoy. Alright, looks like Naraka is ready. Both players are ready. Only practice going with Lars. Naraka going with Claudia. Only practice looking way stronger this time. Already getting Naraka down to 50%. Good throw break. Both players are slugging. Looking very even. Just like the round scores. Oh, throw, nice break. With punch KO. And it's a round for Naraka. 2-1.
Round 4. Fight.
I like his aggressiveness. Naraka is going at it. When did Only Practice lose all that life? When did he lose all that life? Naraka, that was almost the perfect. Just makes it over, Only Practice. And he's happy. Looks like in this set, it's Team Resurrection with a good team morale. Last time, it was Team 3 Generations with the better team morale who took the set eventually. Let's see if the same thing happens here. And because Only Practice has also lost, we have so far, he does have another chance also, but so far the only players to pick Elisa and Lars have lost. Is there, maybe that's a reason why people haven't picked them? I hope I'm proven wrong. Alright, coming up next, it's gonna be Team Resurrection and Naraka, obviously, up 2 games, versus Azez Hao. Hao playing Fang. Hao's trademark character, strong as Fang, by common consensus in Korea. Arakov doesn't care. He's gonna keep doing what he's been doing. Launcher into big damage. Arakov can take this. One mix-up. No, Hao gets a counter hit. Now Hao's chance. Throw does not get broken. Now we all of a sudden we have an even round, but Arakov with a good block into punish for the round. Arakov looking very strong. Flame installed. That two-hitting low move, you only get that with flame. As you can see, he doesn't have the flame anymore because he used it up in that round. Claudio looking very strong in Narakov's hand. How with rage. He's low parry. Oh, he wanted the mix up. How did that shoulder miss? Narakov even getting lucky. 2-0. Look at the damage. That's now 3 hits on Hauser. How quickly tying it up. Narakov. Big combo. Flame installed.
KO.
Too good. Narakov. Is Team Azir still gonna smile in response to Narakov? It's almost turning into a comp now. 3-1. Resurrection 3. Team Azir 1. Up next, we have Team Azir's ace going with Heihachi. And going up against ace is Narakov, who's on a roll. Narakov too strong. I could see why he's playing Claudio. It fits his style very well, you know. Narakov known for being very aggressive, very good with mix-ups. And Claudio looks like fits his style very well. A very good aggressive character, and has a lot of mix-ups to play with, especially when he has the flame install. And Narakov
round one
versus
fight
ace. Narakov has 3 wins, 3 consecutive wins so far. Nice low carry. The combo into corner carry. Throw gets broken. That throw actually gave Narakov way out of the corner. And it's Narakov quickly landing a combo. Ace cornered. But ace with a counter hit. Oh, he missed it. The combo. He made it back.
KO.
Nice mix up.
Round
ace.
Two.
One round up.
Fight.
1-0. Where did that hockey come from? Oh, not quite the most optimal damage, but it's still more than half. Narakov is doing everything he can to fix the angle so that he's not cornered. Not a very smart play. Both players trading hits. These guys are not taking time to fish around. They're going right at each other. Nice whip punish. Ace. Ready.
Round three. Fight.
Narakov. Slowly starting his aggression. Ace, right back at him also, with his own. He did the throw again in that situation, in a corner situation. Maybe he has some options that I'm not aware of. The first time he did it, it put Narakov out of the corner. Narakov needs more damage from this combo. It's a mix-up. Ace can do it right here. But no, Narakov. With a great comeback.
Round four. Fight.
He's in the zone right now, as you just saw. Ace wants to finish it off. Nice punish on the hop kick. I love those cinematics. Tekken 7 looks really hype. Tarkov.
KO.
We're tied up. 2-2.
Fight.
Tarkov wants it big. He's going for the hop kick right away at the start of the round. Ace. It's slowly inching into the corner. Pressuring. Tarkov not getting the mix-ups he wants to do. It's all Ace right now. Back to neutral. Players fishing hard. Using all the time they have. Playing a little more safe. But it's Tarkov who pulls out the hop kick first. Flames installed and Whiff Punish baited. Tarkov 4 wins straight. You can see Deez with a slight smirk on his face. You know he's happy. He's hoping he doesn't even have to play. Aze, on the other hand though, is down to the last two players. And they haven't even seen Team Resurrection's testing, which is me. They need to pull something very big right now. Understandably, the team morale for Team Aze isn't looking very good right now. But you have to do it. It's now or never.
Fight.
Tarkov versus only practice. Tarkov with the offense. Tarkov always being the aggressor. Usually first. And then the other guy is forced to play the game that Tarkov is bringing to him. Oh, that was a critical low that got blocked. And Tarkov almost doesn't have it.
KO.
Oh, that was just a 50-50. Unlucky for only practice. But that was a very close round. Oh, look at the damage! Tarkov! Cornered! Knee! Practice is too much! Not letting the other guy breathe at all! Pressure over and over! Hop kick! Everything just working in Narakov's favor.
Round 3. Fight!
The other players just can't breathe! Too much! Needs to convert this. Mix up. He's going for a lot of safe choices, only practice that is. Alright, he has the mix up chance. Baited. Right, this is his chance. One hit. Tarkov gets one chance.
KO.
Only practice.
Round 4.
Edges it out.
Fight.
2-1. Tarkov still with game points. Tarkov is bullying everybody. Alright, now he's letting the other guy breathe for some reason, Tarkov that is. Only practice needs to adapt to this sudden change of style. Seems to be doing well, but Tarkov misses the combo. This is only practice's last chance. One hit can do it. Oh, hop kick does not get punished. And Tarkov once again just bulldozing through everybody. Yeah, just those knee pressures too much. If I had to play him right now, I wouldn't know what to do either. The pressure is just too much. He's on fire right now. Team Aze is on their last leg. Their captain Pao has to win 5 consecutive games to take this match for his team. Taking a little sip. He needs it right now. He definitely needs it. Barakov discussing a little with me. Matchup's gonna be Claudio versus Fang. How is Fang gonna be enough to stop Barakov rampage? Barakov is stretching. He's having fun.
Round one. Fight.
Barakov again going for a very aggressive stuff. How slowly starting his game. Slowly pushing Barakov. Now pressuring him with his own jabs. Oh, trades in Al's favor. Barakov with a critical jump kick to wrap up round one. He's getting very close to taking this for his team. Once again, Hao has a better end of the stick with that trade. But likewise, looking very even so far. But Hao gets a launch. Wall carry. Mix-up gets blocked. Hop kick! Is this gonna be enough? Not quite. One more. Barakov, not gonna wait.
Three. Fight.
Match point for Team Resurrection. Barakov lands a throw. Hao needs this. Hao needs something to happen, something big right now. To shift the momentum. Take the tide away from Barakov. This might be it.
KO.
Two lows gets Hao the first round for this game.
Fight.
You can just see the adrenaline in Hao's face. A little slower start. Barakov looking for the chance to start his offense. A counter hit. Hao. The pressure from Hao is starting. Nice break this time. Flame has been installed. You don't get to see that whiff like that very often. Barakov almost has it. Oh, that might not work. How? That was lucky. How did do something. He stepped something out, but Barakov was just slightly too slow with his rage charge. It's blocked, and it's now 2-2. Final round. Barakov can still do this with the first team. How slowly getting that life lead. Nice punish. One more hit and Hao finally stops the beast that is Barakov. Finally a little smile on Team Az's faces. But Barakov he can't be sad about that. He did what he could. He put four points on his side for his team. And it's now me for Team Resurrection, Team Captain, going with Shaheen. The first time we're going to be seeing me, also a former Evolution Tekken Champion. Let's see if his new character choice, Shaheen,
round one,
is gonna pay for it. He's opting for a lower start. Backdashing. How? Taking the advantage to corner his knee. But it's knee to get the first combo. Once again, launch. This could be big. One hit.
KO.
Nice control match. By D, takes round one. Oh, Nice counter hit. The angle is kind of awkward, and he has to end the combo with a long carry to the corner. Oh, nice slide. Changes the screen position. Jeez, making quick work of Hao. Hao.
Round three. Fight.
Not knowing how to compose himself again. Makes a huge whiff. Loses round two. Now it's match point for Team Resurrection once again. Hao. Doing. Looking for a chance. Looking for that hold. But Nii is not giving it to him easily. He's playing very safe. Now, has him cornered. Rage Art is gonna land. And Nii is gonna take it for Team Resurrection. What a good call. How are you not gonna press it? How are you not gonna press something in that situation if you're a Hao? Good call by Nii. Team Resurrection moves on to the main tournament. Team Resurrection is done for the day. They can now go home or watch other teams play who might be their possible opponents. Team Resurrection will now move on to the main tournament, while Team Aze still has another chance. They will have another chance to play against other teams in their pool, in their respective pool. And they might still be able to make it to the main tournament. Team Resurrection looking very strong. You have Nii, who's always going to be a favorite to win any tournament in the world. But then it was Narakov who took his team to almost the top. And it was the captain Nii who just capped it off. Looked very confident, very easy almost. Resurrection looking very, very strong. Can't wait to see more from Team Resurrection in the main tournament in 2 weeks. And let's see who we have for our next matchup. The next matchup, it's up in the air, because right now, most of the matches coming up would be the qualifying matches from each pool. And if I'm not mistaken, it might be Pool D's qualifying match that's coming up. Pool D has the Regeneration. Pool D also has, on the other side, has Team Serena. Let's see what players are in Serena after the break. I'll be back in 30 minutes, guys.